think we can look at it from purely like fashion perspective. For example, how certain brands such as like a Guidance or Martin Rose take cues from sports and incorporate into their designs. Or we could be talking about how athletes are coming, the new style influencers and NBA tunnels, kind of the new catwalks, or even the more kind of business level integration, such as the rumored LVMH AC Milan deal. So my first question is, what does it mean to you guys?
Moncler is already the sponsor of Inter Milan. So every time you look at an Inter Milan game, you see them wearing Moncler all the way, where back in the days, a lot of the high-end brands look at football especially as something of the lower class, sort of say. So there was a presence of the mass brands like McDonald's or Heineken.
I think football shirts are being worn as fashion items. So I think there's going to be a shift of football clubs also presenting them as fashion items. And I think it's already happening.
The business potential there obviously is quite large if we're thinking about sport and fashion as entertainment entities. You know, I think it's a multi-billion dollar industry now, especially thinking about how entertainment on the field and in the stadium, all the way to, you know, the digital pieces of that. It's a kind of a full circle opportunity both for brands, teams, and fans to really get involved.
It has always been there, but now it's because it's recognized by high end, this conversation starts to get an interesting turn. It's good to challenge the idea of when is it like a verified fashion thing, and who decides that, you know? They are kind of late to the party in a way.
But it's funny that you say it's been there all the time, because for women it really isn't. We're really working on performance as well as high fashion, but I think the performance is where there is now way much more to do, while men actually dress up going to the court. So I think that's really nice, because I feel like sometime at some point it will come together and hopefully there is some equality in it.
What makes athletes good style influencers? Why are they so popular for brands?
I think it has a lot to do with skill.
Athletes have always been celebrities, right? They have stories, they're authentic, right? Like, they're not doing fashion for fashion's sake, they have a story to tell, and I think there's an alignment there, you know? And that's, it goes beyond fashion, it goes deeper to like morals and values.
Athletes are more than ever speaking up about what they believe in, where you used to see brands stepping away from that because it was too tricky. Now you really see brands stepping towards that because they already have the platform.
Probably a bit about community as well, isn't it? Because sports people and athletes and clubs, they come with a community, and obviously that's catnip for brands.
On the skate track, they wanted to wear TNO. So we developed their outfits for them. And they actually performed on the Olympic Games in the New Originals, which is such a small brand in comparison to all these massive brands that are out there. But it was the athletes themselves that said, no, I wanna wear this.
I think it was like 5 years ago, Hector Bellerin, like an Arsenal player, he decided that suits that they were wearing should not be sponsored by this lame brand. The shift started with athletes demanding change. And now I think the bigger brands are also seeing like, hey, there's a big culture there, and let's work together.
I also agree, but I do think they are way more challenged. And that's also what you're saying. They have to tap into more middlemen in order to achieve that aesthetic or achieve that type of product, and awaken some old products from the past, because the interpretation of the culture is way different than people up in some office towers.
Big brands like Nike, like Adidas, I mean, they have staying power because they have these iconic models, these iconic makes that have been so cemented in culture.
But I think in a few years, the tables are going to be turned, and that Nike will need Cortez to stay relevant. So I think that's going to be a bit of a change, where Cortez can demand stuff and not Nike, because it like, or Adidas for that matter.
But then now brands really need to start tapping into being there for everyone and opening up for all sorts of people.
I think my take on your question, I don't know who it's going to be, but I would love to break the trope of the male creative director, because it's getting old. I would love it to be a woman.